Good afternoon. We're so happy that you're here, and we're so happy. We're so happy that we have a transfer date. My lining looked great. We are transferring in 5 days on September 10th. So that was a great start to my morning. We daily vlog. So if you like this video, we hope that you'll come back tomorrow. And now I'm going to cook some red sauce for dinner and just to have in the house. So yeah, I'll time lapse that. So here it is. It's a little like thicker than usual. I accidentally got crushed tomatoes instead of diced. But it still tastes yummy. The zucchini is a little weird. I chopped it into pieces from like the zoodles. But I'm just going to have this cook like basically until Peter gets home from work on low. I have a little bit more basil to add to it. I just don't like when like the basil flavor totally is gone. So I like to add some more like towards the end so that it's like fresher in taste.
Here I am in the parking lot of the post office, just filling my tire up. So just got off work, gonna stop at the P.O. box. I'm actually in the parking lot for the P.O. box and gonna get our mail. We should have the fanny pack and we should have other mail because that's where we're forwarding our mail to in between our apartments. So we should have some mail. I know we at least have a fanny pack, so kind of excited to check it out because it's been closed because of the storm.
Here we go. Oh, no mail yet? What? That's crazy.
We got our fanny pack. I just love that our logo shows up on the address, like on the shipping label. So cool.
Look at these delicious bowls. Jess came over and got Katie some balloons and flowers.
I'm home and I got this.
Love it.
We'll show this more after dinner because I'm starved.
So here are the same, basically the same instructions as we got for the fresh embryo transfer. Just a little bit more information about the progesterone and oil injections. Really quick, I'm going to show a needle. So if you don't want to watch, I'll put the time where you should skip across to. I'm not going to show it going in me or anything. I'm just going to show a needle.
Just in a sealed container.
Yeah. Okay, so here is my progesterone and oil. It's much thicker than any of the other liquids. This is the needle that I'll use to pull it up into the syringe. And then this is the doozy of a needle that will go inside my rear end. It's actually like more like my lower back, but still somewhere I'm not going to show on the vlog. And that is what puts the intramuscular medicine in. But I'm still just on this estradiol.
6 pills a day. I didn't realize it was going to be the 6 pills a day. How long do you do estradiol?
Potentially for 11 weeks into the pregnancy.
So I didn't realize that she'd be doing the 6 pills a day and the 1 oil shot a day, potentially through 11 to 12 weeks into pregnancy.
Okay, let's do this. So Peter just put the other needle on. The medicine's all in. Here we go.
All right, first shot, done. I can't believe we're gonna be end up doing needle shots for 11 weeks or more. Maybe yeah. 13 weeks?
14, worth it.
14 weeks, because it's 1 week of shots, 2 weeks of waiting, and then, well, it would be the 11th week, so that would be something. So still like 11, 12 weeks.
If you don't know, progesterone is basically something that makes the body feel as though it's pregnant. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times that is what people lack when pregnancies aren't successful. And so it is really important, especially when you're going through IVF, that you have that.
And so for a lot of women, if we have a lot of family members and family, and family and friends that found out they needed to take that like almost like a supplement during their pregnancies.
Right, even if they didn't go through IVF.
And we keep saying 11 weeks because around 11 to 12 weeks, like the baby is cooked enough that it kind of makes that that
basically
on its
the
own.
First trimester.
Yeah. So cool. Well, we gotta change and get out of here. It's 6:35 and we gotta go watch some Illuminations.
Oh gosh, where is it? Did you guys just see the castle?
You can kind of see there's the Tron construction.
Yeah.
And Bay Lake right behind it. And space, I just saw Space Mountain.
With us staying in Winter Garden for the time being, we take the back roads.
There's a northern back road by Casper Parking, and if you look forward, this is actually gorgeous. This is a brand new road called Flirty and White that they just extended.
Mm-hmm. So we'll pop up right by the Grand Floridian. We'll come up on the west side of Magic Kingdom. I secretly love monorail line.
Good thing we got a fast pass for this, Sarah. We don't know what the wait times are looking like today yet, but Sarah nabbed a couple fast passes on the way in just to be safe. But clearly this is a walk in. Oh, I can already smell it. I'm gonna get this tattooed on my back.
We have been among its
best. Best line in the whole place.
But where do we go? And what kind of future will we discover this? Surprisingly, the answers lie in our past. Here we are, a truly global community, poised to shape the future of this, our spaceship Earth.
I think every citizen of the world should start their day off with the Brookhart Project 1-2 special. And it is called Spaceship Earth and Beverly. Everyone would live to at least 175.
Wow.
And there'd be no more war or hunger or sadness. Lack of alphabet knowledge because of the Venetians.
Right.
Or sadness.
Oh yeah. The greatest thing about food and wine is Club Cool, hosted by Coca-Cola.
It's closing on Saturday.
This is closing Saturday. This is closing Saturday.
Yes.
This is closing Saturday?
This might be our last time here.
What?
This might be our last time here.
No, we're coming Saturday.
What if it closes Saturday and it's not open Saturday? We gotta check.
Okay, at least it's still here for now. But we're gonna ask the cast member if tomorrow's the last day. Or if Saturday's the last day.
It will be open Saturday, but Saturday will be the last day. It'll be open. I didn't think it was gonna happen this soon.
It's gonna be reimagined. I know. Some way or another.
I know it's not.
But it was good that we can come back on Saturday.
Yeah, I know it's not gonna be gone forever. I just thought we had more time with it before it was gonna leave us.
Hold on here. I had Scarlett on
me. I had Beverly, I'm Beverly, and I'll have one more Beverly.
It makes sense that like they're just not refilling them. I wonder if Beverly's even gonna make it to Saturday. Beverly number 3, last of the day. Beautiful skies, almost no lines for fruit and wine booths over there. Sarah, the struggle is real right now.
No.
We already ate. We said we're being better about our diets. Like our, not our diet
be
diets, but like our daily consumption. Like our everyday diet.
Yeah.
Not that we are on a diet, because we are not on a diet.
Right, no. But yeah, the urge to eat a lot of food.
If we can make it through food and wine and stay vegan, we can stay through, we can survive anything.
And that's a big fat if on that statement. I can just see it now. I think we're gonna make it, but if we didn't, it would be a bad downward spiral because then we'd go straight into the holidays, straight into the Thanksgiving, Christmas
Chicago, the
Chicago's weddings, the cruise. It would just be.
You said everything I said. Peter just said, do you want to go get your favorite shot that you always get when we're here? And yes I do.
This is our fanny pack, food and wine fanny pack, bum bag.
Our little silverware, super nice.
It's much wider than I thought. Got my sunnies.
Wow.
I got one utensil, two utensil, tripod, car key. I have my cell phone in here sometimes, and then there's an inside pocket. You can, so there's a big pocket, then the little pocket. Little pocket's got some backup batteries.
Ooh.
So pretty awesome.
Yeah, nice size.
Really nice size. We'll put the link down below, but they come in a variety of colors. And right now, we make no money off it. Every purchase, they're
$35? They're $35, yeah.
Every purchase, we make a $10 donation to our American Cancer Society fund. Oh, and then the top, my favorite table. And then, of course,
all the different
tables.
Trash cans.
Or yes, as most of the world knows them as trash cans.
This is Grace Kelly. She's playing a little saxophone. Look at this big mint.
I almost don't even mind this has the year on it.
Isn't that cute?
It's that cute, and it's nice and ceramic-y. And a point to pour.
This is cute. A cute little hat.
I don't know why, and put a comment down below if you had this feeling about any pavilion in particular, but for some reason the UK pavilion always just like brings me out of Epcot. Like when we're in the back there just hanging around or walking through the shops, either side of the shops, like the rock and roll or the football side or the tea and jewelry side, like we're just perusing around the back side. I just like it.
You really don't feel like you're
at Epcot. I feel like I'm in the UK.
It's a big pavilion.
It is, like when you think of all the eateries, like bars and food here, yeah. All of the stores, all that space in the back, and they're gonna add an attraction.
It's a big pavilion.
I think it's my favorite pavilion.
I feel like it's another quiet night at the park. Like how we said, like when we got to Magic Kingdom yesterday, just like felt quiet.
Oh, yes. Just think like, we just vlogged this entire walk through UK and you guys didn't hear anybody screaming rowdy party signs, which is like insane. We didn't see what the wait was for Frozen, but it was a walk-on for Spaceship Earth. It's probably gonna be a not bad wait for Test Track. Crowds are not even, they're barely lining up for Illuminations and we're 30 minutes away.
Quiet. I mean, I guess September does get kind of quiet before the holidays. So.
It is like, we always forget, there's like a solid week and a half in early September where it's like, which is great. It's
like between Labor Day.
Yeah.
And like when Halloween really starts to get in.
Halloween starts tomorrow. We'll talk about that later.
What the heck did we not know about?
Peter just says this reminds him of the Run Disney morning.
I'm ready. We're like 58 days away from food and wine. Super pumped because I'm super ready.
Oh, for wine and dine.
Yeah.
It
wine,
is food and dine.
Sorry, wine and dine. Running 5K with some friends. My goal is if the weather, really, as long as the weather is working in my favor, I'm going to try to kill my PR for the half marathon.
No, I'm not a writer.
Okay.
That marks, what, halfway? Kind of halfway? That
was our... We've only done five.
Of 11.
Yeah, but it's not quite.
It's almost halfway. Because then the next one will be over halfway.
True.
So it's like we're kind of in a weird halfway through seeing Illuminations from all the countries. I am not...
We're going to see it more, though, because like when we're with the Earharts, because they're going to be here that last week. We're going to see it from multiple different spots with them.
I'm just not ready. And I'm not okay.
The girls are watching some comedy series and I'm about to go run 10 miles.
So naturally we go out hoping
you
to
can
be
do
discovered
it.
And I'm back. 12:08 in the morning, 10 miles. I think it goes at 10:03. Pretty good. I need to go take a shower, I smell, and go to bed.
Peter's showering and running and we're having a midnight snack.
Yeah, you got.
Okay, I can actually. Can I talk? No. I have to talk in my throat. Judging.
So we literally spent the past 2 hours.
Looking good!
Like Mike was upset. Watching this race car driver's Instagram page. We'll link it below.
It's really funny.
Really funny. Katie watched your first episode of Queer Eye. What did you think?
Mine was the first one. Watch my first one.
That was the first one. That was like the first episode. That one I showed you.
You Can't Fix Ugly?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, that's the first one. There are so many better ones.
But it was good. It was like, I used to love What Not to Wear.
Yeah.
Bring back Stacey.
It's like Extreme Makeover Home Edition.
Plus Makeover. Plus.
Plus every, like, Food Network. I don't know. Watch Queer Eye if you have it.
Here is our snack that I tried to explain.
What are these again?
Cinnamon sugar pita chips with dessert hummus brownie batter hummus.
It's so good, you guys.
Yeah, delicious.
All right, I'm all cleaned up and everything. I'm hurting. So there's this weird thing, and like, I'm sure anybody who has weird stomach issues or also and or athletes can attest. I forgot that when I eat tomato-based things like the awesome sausage that I made, that messes my stomach when I run. My stomach's hurting. You know, the girls just took the dogs out and they came back in. I'm just like talking to myself for you guys. But, oh, Katie told me when I said, I think it's because I ate the tomato sauce. She goes, Tom Brady said in her Bostonian self.
No, I read an article very about Boston. Tom Brady's personal chef about like his diet. And he doesn't eat tomatoes before game days.
It has nothing to do with the fact that you're from Boston.
Okay, time for bed. Nothing can bring you peace but yourself. Ralph Waldo Emerson.
Today was a good day.
Today was a good day.
But ending on an
upset stomach for my run. Tomorrow's HHN and Friday. And we're super glad you're here with us all the time.
Thank you so much for hanging out and for coming along for the ride. And for all the well wishes already, because we posted on social media about the new transfer date. One day closer. It's good to be home.
Good to be home.
We know what our goals are. We know what we hope to accomplish. And believe me, it's the most exciting and challenging assignment we've ever tackled at Walt Disney Productions.